सर विद परमिशन मैं एक्चुअली रेजिडेंट पिक्चरेशन विलेज फॉर अ फोर्टी मिलियन थाना सिटी गोपाली जिला ऑन 30/11/2020 इन द इवनिंग एट 7 PM सिमिलरली एट A1 A2 बिकॉज ऑफ ओपन ड्रेनेज टूअर्ड देयर ब्लॉक स्टार्टेड टू अप्यूज बी एंड वी वेंट अप टू सी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग आउटसाइड A1 and A2 चेक बी विद लाठी इनसाइड द हाउस एंड असल्टेड बी बिकॉज ऑफ विच बी विद बी सस्टेन ब्लीडिंग इन रीच ओवर हेड एंड राइट आर्म हिज वाइफ डब्ल्यू ट्राइड टू सेव हिम सी आल्सो सस्टेन ब्लीडिंग इन रीच ओवर लेफ्ट आर्म एंड राइट लेग and other family members of B and neighbors came and shouted to save B and W. Both the accused person intimidated B by threatening to cause death and fled away. From the place of incident, B immediately went to Vichia Hospital, Rewa, along with W. And after discharge from the hospital on 4/12/2020, immediately on in the morning at or about 8 AM. Informant B lodged a first information report with police station. Thereby, police registered a case under crime number 946/20. Accused A1 and A2 were arrested. Lathis were also seized from them, and after completion of investigation, charge sheets against A1 and A2 was filed.
There are number of evidences has been provided in the cases. As we have already witnessed that 5 witnesses are there. As prosecution witness 1 is B, who himself is a victim and has suffered the injury because of accused A1 and A2. And second one is W, which is the wife of the B. And third one is her brother, who has also also supported the statement of the prosecution. And the third prosecution witness, the fourth prosecution witness is the doctor, who has also supported the prosecution proceeding. And last fifth one is the investigation officer, who has prepared the charge sheet along with all the proofs and statements and all the facts and with all the proceedings. As when just was stated and when we was sitting in his living room, suddenly accused A1 came and start abusing him, and when he went out to see who was abusing and what is happening, they seized him and crashed into the house, and they started beating him, which caused him a bleeding injury in his right side of the head and right side of the leg. It was a grave injury, as the doctor report has been provided and clearly mentioned there that B caused a grave injury in his right side of the head and right side of the leg. And then his wife who came there to save him from such such things, and then they also started beating him with the lathis. And then B also caused the big injury on the left side of his leg and left side of his hand also. And then all his brother and all the other neighbors came there and tried to save them. And then they, by threatening them and giving them the threat to death, he left from there. And all these things, it just happened because of the mere cause, a small issue, as they are saying that it happened because of the drainage issue. Which is in their plot, and both the father and son, accused one and accused two, had stated to be that we have having the problem just because of a mere issue. They have caused such bleeding injuries to us. And as I have already provided the evidences, now I would like to continue with the charges. It has been final report. First, when there are two accused involved, accused one and accused two, so. This is called the Section 34 of Indian Penal Code for common intention with further proceeding. And then when they have started abusing them, and for abuse there is the 504th section, intentional insult with the intent to provoke breach of the peace. And then when they started shouting and abusing, and when we went out, they seized him to the house. Then start beating. So section 547 is also applied there for punishment for criminal trespass. And then as they have threatened him to the death and given him threat to death. 500 section for criminal intimidation is also there. And then, as he has the grave injuries and heart cause, then section 325 and 323 is also applicable here. And just because of provocation and assaulting, so section 352, punishment for assault of criminal force, is also applicable there. And I don't think so there is much argument needed, because all the facts are stating themselves, all the causes, as defense has no proceeding to deal with and no have such big evidences which is reliable.
Counsel's explanation for the defense plea. Both the accused persons advance defense that the complainant has angry because they are prohibited complainant from the drainage water and their block. Second, the complainant and his wife fell down from the motorcycle. It was not a pre-planned incident. And they lost a false complainant to take the advantage of the situation. The evidences of the defenses are: accused persons has denied all the inculpated circumstances were put to them in the examination of section 313 of the CRPC. Accused person examined his neighbor N, who was disposed that the plot of A is beside the house of B, and all the water from his drainage is collected in the plot, making it in a marshland. A1 and A2 are the father and son. A1 and A2 requested B many times to arrange for the arrangement of the drainage, but instead of this, B, who is a well-to-do person, did not do anything. Municipal officer also lodged a false report against the A1 and A2. B has recently purchased a new motorcycle, that's why he was unable to control it and fell down. Due to falling from the motorcycle, they caused various injuries.
Agreement for defense are: there is variation in medical and ocular evidence. No independent witness has been examined by prosecution, and there is considerable unexplained delay in lodging FIR of 4 days. The story of prosecution is false, because 30 November 2020 was a public holiday of Guru Purnima and Kartik Purnima and Guru Nanak Jayanti. Hence, question of coming from the office by complainant is false. The standard of their defense, as is pronounced preponderance of probability, so they are entitled to be exonerated from the charges which they are subjected to trial. Some case references are State versus Sri Haldardas. In this case, the light of aforesaid discussion and reasons, it is seen that the prosecution side failed to prove the guilty of the accused person. Accordingly, the accused person Sri Haldardas acquitted from the offence under section 294 out of 325 of IPC, and he is set at liberty for good. I want recommended for the prayer from the side of defendant. Defendant are not liable for the punishment under are mentioned already in file. Prosecution files a false complaint against defendant under sections 352, 504, 323, 325, 506, 448, 34 Indian Penal Code. I request to the Honorable Court to set aside the matter lodged on defendant.
Thanks, Because all the injuries which has been caused, and the neighbors and wife also, nobody self-harmed themselves for such big things. So this feeling is absolutely incorrect. And then about as they said that it is the there is a difference, or there is a FIR proceeding, which is not of the 4 days. I have not been correct. It is mentioned 3 days. And these 3 days is also mentioned in the doctor's report. Doctor himself, not only on the document, but his verbal and oral, he also said that there is a various injuries, because of which after as sudden as on the same date on which the doctor passed them and allowed them to go home, on the same date within 1.5 hours they have lost the information report. So I don't think so there is any reasonable delay on that. And another thing, they are saying about the holiday, or government holiday. So I would like to tell that the report came on 2020. There are certain states mentioned where these holidays are applicable, and the Rewa, Kothwari state are not mentioned there. So the holiday thing is also invalid. so I all these facts are already stated and I don't think defense have anything else to say. Cases also. As Muthu Nepper and Oswald State of Tamil Nadu, on 10th August 1971, Akhil had been convicted. In this case, also the several charges are being charged as Section 325, 504 and 506. And on other different cases of Mahadev Prasad Kaushik versus State of UP, they had also the similar case in which they have a grave provocation. So it is also on the favor of the prosecution. Accused got convicted in the section of 325 on 17 October. And there is a Kuruma Shikhant versus State of Maharashtra and other. In this section also, the main issue was for the section 504 and other, and here also the case get convicted.
Sir, we want to refute the statement by prosecution that on this is the case of 13th November, which are reported on 4th December. According to the Medical Practitioner Act, no doctor shall perform any medical securance for the patient without informing latest police station. First point. Second point. This is a matter of drainage. इतने बार मना करने के बाद भी ड्रेनेज करने का कारण क्या है? अदर पॉइंट जो प्रोसिक्यूशन ने अपने स्टेटमेंट में कहा कि वहाँ पे नेवर्स थे, अगर इतने सारे नेवर्स थे तो किसी ने बचाया क्यों नहीं? इन्होंने एक और पॉइंट बोला है कि वाइफ को हर्ट हुआ है और जो वो प्रोसिक्यूशन थे उनको ग्रेवियस हर्ट हुआ है। अगर लाठी से किसी को मारा जाए, एक ही लाठी से मारा जाए, तो अलग अलग कैसे हो सकता है? जैसे कि डिफेंडेंट ने कहा कि एक्सीडेंट हुआ, तो एक्सीडेंट में ये संभव है जो गाड़ी चला रहा है उसको ज़्यादा हार्म हुआ, लेकिन अगर किसी को लाठी से ही मारा जाए तो हर्ट तो हो ही नहीं सकता, दोनों को ग्रेवियस हर्ट होना चाहिए। एक पॉइंट। दूसरा पॉइंट ये भी था कि प्रोसिक्यूशन ने कहा है कि अभी कुछ इन्होंने अपने स्टेटमेंट कहा है कि इन्होंने कुछ दिन पहले बाइक ली थी, तो इन्होंने बाइक ली थी तो इनके पास ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस, अगर आप प्रोसिक्यूशन स्टेटमेंट देखें तो उसमें लिखा है कि इन्होंने कुछ दिन पहले ही बाइक ली थी, अगर आप देखें तो इन्होंने बाइक ली थी तो इनके पास ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस नहीं होगा, मतलब इन्होंने ड्राइविंग टेस्ट भी नहीं दिया होगा, अगर ड्राइविंग टेस्ट नहीं दिया होगा तो ये भी स्वाभाविक है कि इनका एक्सीडेंट हुआ होगा। अदर पॉइंट ये है कि वेरिएशन भी इंजरी में है, और 30 नवंबर को जो उन्होंने बोला कि हॉलीडे पे आने के बाद उसने मारपीट आके इनके घर के पास की, 30 नवंबर को जैसा कि मैं पहले बता चुका हूँ, गुरु पूर्णिमा, गुरु कार्तिक पूर्णिमा, गुरु नानक जयंती की सरकारी हॉलीडे, तो उस दिन वो ऑफिस से कैसे आया?
It is happening for the motorcycle, and why a wife is having the hurt and the husband having grievous. And they are saying it has happened because of the motorcycle. So we all are here adults, and we know when the motorcycle fall down, it will fall down on the one side. Then why wife is having the left side injuries and the husband is having the right side injury? There is no fact. No wife will be fall down on the both side. It will be fall down on the one side. So it should be the both the injury should be on the right side or both the injury should be left. And as in having caused the grievous hurt to the husband, because the main issue is connected with the husband, and they have requested the husband. We are not denying the fact that they have requested several times for the drainage. Even if this this issue, there is a court and there is other proceedings involved, which they can take in their defense, not by beating him somebody with the lathis. And about the doctor, we are saying that Doctor not had seen this statement when the investigation officer has gone to him and asked for the father's surgery, then also he has given the submitted the report to the investigation officer. And the holiday point have I already clear, we are not here to repeat the facts and
State versus Sri Haldardas. In the light of aforesaid discussion and the reason it is seen that the prosecution side failed to prove the guilty of the accused person, accordingly, the accused person Sri Haldardas the basis is acquitted from the offence under section 294 out of 325 of IPC and he is set at liberty forthwith. Sir, I want to ask for a prayer to the Honorable Court to grant relief and justice to the accused for the damages. Accused are not liable for the punishment, or defendant are not liable for the punishment, and as mentioned already in false prosecution, files a false complaint against defendant under section 352.504, 323, and 325.506 and 448 of the Indian Penal Code. I request to the Honorable Court to set aside the matter laws as defendant.